Hi, in this Lightboard session, we're going to talk about processing records or looping over records. Now, we've got a bunch of options available to us. Now, the first one to consider is, am I just transforming a collection at a structure level? Am I changing the structure and mapping it? In that case, Dataweave. So you've got a Dataweave transform, which is ideal for this sort of use. So that's your first option. You've got map function that you could use to do that. So don't think you need to do anything too complex as far as using other scopes. Now, when you need to execute lines of code or event processes for each record, that's when you have to start considering using scopes. Now, the simplest one to start with your looping needs would be the for each scope. For each scope has an ability to put bits of flow code, event processes inside the scope, and it will loop over executing that for each record. Now, remember, there's also a mode with this that you can say you want to do it in chunks. So you want to do it 2 records, 10 records at a time. So there is the ability to do bulk operations inside here if you need a mini collection out of your overall collection. Now, this is looping sequentially, and it is a single-threaded thing. If you want to throw multiple threads at the problem, then you've got to think about some other solutions. So to that end, batch is more moving parts. It's got a work queue that it maintains. It has a series of steps that you take each record through. And then it's got an on complete, which will give you a summary of how everything's going. So batch, multiple threads, getting things through in a greater or with a greater amount of processing thrown at it, unlike for each, which is sequentially processing, and it does have an ability to give you a summary at the end. Now, the final one, based on what you know, is the use of queues, because queues are a way to distribute load as well. So you could push messages into some sort of queue. So we know about VM queues. We could go to JMS, and there are other messaging providers that are a similar sort of capability. Now, VM queues are a built-in capability, so lightweight messaging. When you go to something external, that could be because the consumer needs to be outside the Mule ecosystem, or the producer is outside the Mule ecosystem. So queuing is another way to process records by pushing things into a queue and then having one or more consumers read those in. And those are our 4 options for processing lots of records. When you just need to do structure, just consider Dataweave. When you need to loop over sequentially with a single thread for each. When you need to throw multiple threads at the problem and take each through a series of steps, with the option, like for each, to do bulk operations, because you can do your batch aggregator. And final one is to use queuing. Just to remember that when you're looking to see what's coming out of these, then for each is going to have whatever was passed into it. It doesn't change the structure, unlike the Dataweave transform, which does. And as far as batch, again, whatever was in there at the start, you're not going to be changing the structure. Okay, so to summarize the options, when you're wanting to transform structure, use Dataweave transform, it takes in something, produces something new if you use the map operator or map function. For each, we'll have same payload that you got in as part of whatever the processing happens here doesn't override what you had on the way in. When you're using batch, it's got a batch job result as the output. That'll give you some summary information of the number of records and things like that. And as far as queues, well, it depends on how you use the queue, but generally you're publishing in, and then there is some asynchronous processing. So the answer depends on what you do next, and it'll usually be asynchronously processed. And those are your 4 options for how to process lots of records.